Good evening, students. Pooja ma'am will join in a minute. So please be in the class, and we are waiting for the more students to join the class. Okay. So we will wait for just for more 1 or 2 minutes, and then we'll start. So you guys know what Pooja ma'am is going to take today's class, in today's class, which thing? Mokchit, any idea what ma'am is going to take today? Mukti, any idea? Srinidhi Reddy?
Good evening, sir.
Evening.
Architectural general awareness.
Architectural general
awareness. Knowledge, yeah.
Okay. So in that, what she taught you yesterday? In yesterday's class, what she taught you?
Sir, types of houses yesterday we discussed. Traditional houses.
So have you guys gone through that after the class? I updated it in the app also. Have you guys gone through that? After the class, anyone did the research, because he did the research in the class also. So I'm just asking you guys, you guys have done it or not. So otherwise, if you guys didn't done it, then we have to see how we have to do it. Okay. So just I wanted like knowledge from you guys. You guys have gone through that or not. So can you please update me on this? Deepthi, Falguni, Janvi Mishra. Kisi ko kuch bolna hai ya nahi bolna hai? So you guys are like ghost? Log bhoot ho sare? Anyone want to talk to us? Mokchit? Vivang?
Yes, sir.
Yesterday you attended the class or not?
Yes, sir.
So I'm asking question means what? So you guys know about it. Have you done the research or not? If yes, tell a yes. If no, tell no, sir. No, sir, I didn't do that. So then we can see how we can approach for this class, how we can go. So if you guys are not talking to us, so how we get to know? We are just finishing the chapter. And if we are going to finish only the chapter, you guys will mark what you are looking for. More than 170 or 180 out of 200. So please be vocal. So Pooja ma'am also get to know about you, and she can give you the exact recipe to get the good marks in the examination. Okay. Okay, Pooja ma'am, now you can continue the class. Pooja ma'am, we are audible to you.
Yes, I wasn't audible to you. Now I am.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Okay, guys. So again, we'll continue with the types of houses today in India, which you guys gave me the names of. Okay. Before that, we'll do a little bit of memory test. Okay, it's not much. Just a few images. Okay, take a pen and paper with you. Okay, I'll give you guys 30 seconds. Okay, I'll start the timer now. Start. stop. Write out how many ever you remember in order. Okay, then I'll give you guys a minute, then I'll show you. It was finished. All right. How many did you guys get correct? Can you guys hear me? No article? Yes, ma'am. Thirteen, okay. Yes, she got 11. Dipti got 14, Shivam got 17, 14, sorry, Shivam got 13, Rahi got 11, Divyesh got 14. Good, good guys, actually. Yeah. I'll show you guys one more image. Okay, then we'll continue with the houses. Okay, keep your pen in. What's the last one? It's a diary. Seems like a diary. Or a calendar, maybe, one of them. Okay. I'll only want 12. Okay, I'll show you guys one more image. Keep your pen and paper ready. I'll set the timer. 30 seconds now also, okay? Start. Stop. Write down all of them, all of those you can remember. When you guys have written the elements, this one, okay, along with how many you've written, just see whether you've written it in correct order also. Okay, that is also important. If you haven't, then again, you'll lose marks. I'll just show you guys. Maybe you guys have done it very quickly. Good enough. Six, 18 are there total images. Seems like you got everything but the last row, most of you guys. Those who got all of them, very good. Rohit got 18. Deepthi got 18. Even if you got less, okay, don't be disheartened. Just an exercise, which we'll be doing again. So you have room to improve. Okay. Any problem in this? Okay. Last class we did traditional houses of North American, South American countries, African countries. Yeah, today we'll do Indian countries, Indian traditional houses, okay? Many of the houses in India, for example, this one, Kachcha house, okay? They don't exactly have a particular region where they were built in, okay? These were the initial vernacular architecture, it's called, okay? Because they were the initial architecture styles, not exactly for aesthetic. It was more about survival, okay, and using available materials to build a house. All the aesthetic appeal need for it came later, that you see in the later architectural styles, okay, where beauty was given as much importance as the utility of it. Okay? So Kachcha house, kind of house. These houses were constructed for nomads, meaning people who moved around a lot, okay, in the initial early stages of civilization, okay, people used to, they started agriculture, they used to build houses near water, first of all, then they started agriculture. That time they built Kachcha houses because that time there were no fertilizers, okay. Sometimes what happened, after you worked in, you know, a patch of field, suppose, after some time it would not grow many plants, would not be very fertilized, that time they would move. So Kachcha houses were built during that time, started building during that time. Then tribal people who moved around a lot, they started building Kachcha houses. A kind of house where the walls are made of bamboo, mud, grass, reed, stones, thatch, straw, leaves, and unburnt bricks are known as Kachcha houses. Spelling is different, okay? You can use it either way. These are not permanent structures of like flats or buildings. Okay? Kachcha houses are usually seen in rural houses or in cities where workers choose makeshift homes. Okay? Investment in pakka houses is expensive, which is why poor opt for temporary structures. Okay? People who are nomads move around a lot, they use it, or people in villages also use rural areas, also use these kind of houses because the other form of construction is expensive. Okay. Now what is reed? You guys might have seen the reed, what it is. You may not know what it's called. So, these type of tall grass is called reed. Okay. You might have seen this, right? Yeah.
What is straw, ma'am?
Straw. Anybody knows what is straw?
Yes, ma'am. They are kind of dried
grass.
Straw leaves, grasses.
Yes. Actually, yeah.
The coconut.
Dried.
Coconut leaves, the dried ones.
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you. What did you say?
The dried leaves.
Yeah, dried leaves, grass is called straw. Okay. In this one, no, where cows and all are tethered, okay, you see the
dried grass, ma'am. Dried grass.
Yeah, dried grass. You see in the bottom, yeah, where for cows to sleep and all, they keep, no, that.
Yeah, yeah, their food.
Yeah. That's a house, okay. Bamboo. This one we saw last time. The Indianized version of it, okay, is used, okay. Next. Chutil, okay, which translates to roundhouse. Okay, it's from a coastal region of Andhra Pradesh. Okay. It's built with mud using cob wall technique. Okay, mixing of mud, water, and sometimes straw to create a robust putty-like material. Okay, the critical aspect here is to get the right consistency. Meaning, if you get the wrong consistency, it will be either very hard, very soft, not be able to construct the wall. Okay. Unlike the thatched roofs of huts that are commonly seen, the ones of the Chutilo usually overhangs and almost touches the ground. Okay, as you can see here. This is to protect the mud walls from harsh climatic conditions, meaning suppose rain. Okay. Also, the slope of the roof must strictly be at a minimum of 45 degrees as well, so that the water doesn't enter the house. Okay. For added protection, a flat inner roof made of timber and mud is constructed before the roof is thatched. Okay. On top of it, a flat roof is constructed made of timber and mud. Okay. Before the roof is touched. Okay. Haveli construction depends on the number of people they're supposed to live there. Okay, and there are many different features, but all havelis have some common features. They were built with a view to provide security and privacy. The design also took into consideration the unforgiving heat and provided adequate ventilation. Where are havelis usually seen?
Rajasthan.
Yes, Rajasthan area where there is a lot very high heat, humidity. Okay, the mansions were designed such that it allowed residents to use various parts of the house during different times of the day. Okay, verandas during cooler hours. Okay, or well shaded rooms for hotter hours. Okay. Considered a symbol of high stature, havelis were influenced by styles from Central Asia, Islamic, Persian, and Rajput architecture. Okay. Initially, I think havelis may have been just purely Rajput architecture, but then influence might have started. Okay. Materials like fire bricks, sandstone, wood, marble, granite, and plaster were some commonly used elements in construction of havelis. If you see havelis, they're very open, as you can see. Okay. They have many open areas and very few rooms which are closed off because of the heat. Next, Koti Banal. I don't know, again, I may be pronouncing it wrong. Okay. See, in the Rajgiri area of Uttarkashi district, Uttarakhand, a large number of intact buildings of distinct construction types known as Koti Banal can be found. Okay. Koti Banal is the name of a village in the Yamuna Valley, which represents the traditional knowledge and understanding of earthquake effects on buildings. Okay. And their earthquake resistant design. These houses that were built, okay, they are constructed to resist severe earthquake. Okay. Investigations suggest that the region had evolved this elaborate and magnificent earthquake safe construction style as early as 1,000 years from the present. Meaning, this style of construction was evolved 1,000 years ago. Okay. This house, particular house that you can see, it's 900 years old. Okay. Is still there. For buildings of the Kotibanal architecture, locally available building materials such as long, thick wooden logs, stones, slates were judiciously used. The height of these structures varies between 7 and 12 meters above the base platform, which consists of dry stones. Okay. Now, the usually they construct about, because no, you in the olden days, people living there were many. Okay, it was a
ma'am. Ma'am, so in this style of housing, like the houses were built like two houses were built identically or like separately, like as shown.
Oh, this is one house.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Again, the construction style was all different based on the number of people. Okay, just show you one more house. It is very huge, actually. This is one house, okay. They were as big as 5-story buildings because a collection of people used to stay there. Maybe they're related or not, that doesn't matter. Okay. These were the type of houses. Bhangas, okay, it's from Kutch, Gujarat. Also, in one of the articles that I read about this construction style, it actually said Bhonga, B-H-O-N-G, that's why I wrote it. Then I searched everywhere else, it's B-H-U, okay? So maybe they know, but it depends based on the place you're from. Vernacular differences based on accent. Bhanga is a traditional construction type in the Kutch district of the Gujarat state in India, okay? Which has a very high earthquake risk. Bhunga consists of a single cylindrically shaped room like this. The bhunga has a conical roof structure supported by, again, cylindrical walls. Its construction has existed for several hundred years. This type of house is quite durable and appropriate for prevalent desert conditions. It's in Gujarat, so desert conditions. The building materials used are masonry walls is made of adobe blocks and plaster, is also from mud covered by cow dung, lime, etc. The roof is made of bamboo, wooden frameworks covered with thatch. Okay. Window has vertical wooden post, wooden rafters. Okay. These houses that you can see in the image are the modernized version of it, okay, because it's very neat, as you can see. The traditional houses, Bhunga houses, were not that neat because they were all about, as I told you, they were all about this one, utility, not aesthetic. This is a kind of traditional house, same construction, okay, except maybe they may use modern techniques for these, okay. You know, the resorts which are local, they use these type of construction, but modern. Mandwa Lodge, okay, again. Maybe wrong pronunciation. It's from Andhra Pradesh coastal area. The houses were built in olden days before the 1950s and 60s, are still found in rural villages of East Godavari, West Godavari, Guntur, Nellore, Vijayanagaram, and Kadapa districts. The walls of these type of houses are constructed with gummy soils or red bricks, and the roofs are supported by logs of rosewood or teakwood. Now see here, rosewood is rare. I mean, construction of it for houses is rare, because you guys know about rosewood? It's a soft kind of wood, not very soft, you know, it cannot be used for construction. Many furnitures and all, they use it, but not very good at withstanding high pressure. Okay? But they can be used here. Okay? Top of the roof are covered with red tiles. The roof of the house is supported by various giant wooden pillars. The center of the common hall is usually topless to let air and light come in. Okay, now, if you see this, the center of the common hall that they're saying, okay, these type of houses where the middle of the house doesn't have a roof is pretty common in South Indian houses. Okay, the rest of the size of the, you know, the open area and the construction of the house may vary, but these type of houses are common. If you have seen South Indian houses, no? This is what I'm talking about. Okay. A pit is constructed on the floor just below the open top, so that rain falls into the pit and from there it goes out of the house through drain. Okay. Some Mandava houses will not have open top, instead it is closed and a pipe is fixed just above. Okay. The rainwater from the top falls into a small constructed pit through the pipe. As you can see, this is the pit. It is below the ground level, below the house level. Okay. All the water is collected here and then it is drained through the pipe. Sometimes when it is closed, the main reason for these type of pit and open areas is light and air. Okay. They don't want air because of rain also. At least light they need. So they may put a like a translucent or something. Okay. Then they use pipes fixed just above so that it again water drains. Okay. Chettinad house. The Chettinad houses were originally single-storied buildings made of sun-dried brick of mud, bamboo, and thatch. They evolved to become tile-roofed with a small two-storied tower at both ends of the front elevation. Okay. Two-storied. They later expanded vertically into two-storied structures horizontally through the addition of numerous halls and courtyards that could accommodate guests at marriages and other ceremonies. It was not unusual for three generations to live together in one house. Okay. The Chettinad houses accommodate up to four generations, the traditional ones, before separate houses are built by individual sons. The traditional houses we are talking about, they were big enough to construct such that four generations could live in that house. Why? That time, no, during those kind of time, there are several types of family units, okay? One is the nuclear family, which we see nowadays, okay? Parents, the children, that's it. Then there's joint family, where brothers, even after marriage, they stay. Then comes extended family. A large number of people stay in one under one roof, okay? In olden days, there were either joint families or extended families, okay? Even if there were no extended families, the houses constructed would be very close by, familiarized on families, okay? So these type of houses would have been very big, okay? Now to you guys. What if it rains heavily? Is there a central opening in Chettinad house? They may or may not be. They have not specifically mentioned, you know, it will be there. They may or may not be. For example, this is there, okay? What if it rains heavily? The construction materials used for these type of houses, all traditional type of houses, basically, they were firm enough to withstand rain. Okay, so that would have not been a problem unless they were kachha houses. Then it would have been. Dungas. Okay, these are basically houses on boats. Okay, long flat bottomed craft, usually 55 feet in length and 6 feet in width. It is usually covered for more than half its length by a wooden, like light wooden roof. Okay, here it's almost completely constructed. These dungas are constructed based on the usability of it. Okay, these were used in Kashmir. These are used in Kashmir actually. That time, I think the when Britishers came in India, I'm not sure about this, but I read it somewhere. When British came in India, in Kashmir, they were not allowed to stay or something like that. Was that? That's why these type of big boat houses were built. Okay, I'm just checking. Until then, there are some boats, some kind of dungas which are extremely small, some where only two people can sit in the back, some like this where they can stay, some are only for trade purposes because they are in Kashmir and all. At that time, they used to do trading on boats. Okay. Oh, yeah, I'm reading from an article. Okay, close to the end of 19th century, Kashmir was opening up to outsiders again, and the outsiders, mostly Europeans, were pouring into the valley. They needed a place to stay for the long holidays. Buying a piece of land and building a house was out of question because the Maharaja of that place, Maharaja Ranbir Singh, wow, would have none of it. No outsider could buy land in Kashmir. Okay. So, there is a dynasty, yes, of course. Otherwise, it would be a difficult problem. That's why Dungas would. Okay, mainly they used to run on Lake Dal, okay, in Kashmir. It's the largest lake in India, if I'm not wrong. The interior is divided by pine planks. Okay, that placement is determined by size of the family, of course. The front triangular space on the deck is used as entrance. Okay. They usually have a triangular this one. Okay. They have triangular, this one, if you can see here. Okay. Next, Mangalore tiles roof house. Okay, this is not specifically a type of house as much as the type of construction. Okay, it's just that tiles are used on the roofs. That's it. Okay, good quality clay selected. How tiles are made? Mangalore tiles. And screen, then it is placed in a mold for cutting to exact dimensions. Then these standard pieces are placed on another machine to imprint the company logo and design. It is later manually adjusted and then sent for firing and glazing. This is the construction of the tiles. and they are used for roofs of the house. That's it. The advantage here is that it remains cool. Okay, these roofs made of clay, so it is porous. It remains cooler. That's the main reason of using this. Cordova houses. A raised plinth made from compacted earth was used as a base to build the Ainimani. See, the Cordova houses are called Ainimani, okay? The walls were built with a combination of mud, rice husk, and resin, which were shaped into blocks. These blocks were laid to a height of 2 or 3 feet before curing. Once the desired height was achieved, the walls were plastered with colored mud mixed with resin, cow dung, and other components, okay? Every house, every Cordova house that is there, it is it's a raised house, okay, as you can see here. It's a raised house, okay? The entrance starts here. This is a platform, okay? Plinth. The raised plinth, okay? Made from compacted earth. What is resin? I think in chemistry you have it. I'm not sure. Anyway, it's a plant-based material. Okay, it's a viscous substance actually. Okay, highly viscous actually. This is the traditional Cordova house or Ainimani, whatever you call it. Okay. The walls are very thick here. If you've seen some Kannada movies, no? In that, if they're showing Cordova culture and all, you will see these type of houses. They are traditional. Guttu houses, okay, the Bund community of Karnataka called their traditional homes Guttu. Bantaru they call it in Kannada. Okay, Guttu mane meaning a home of prestige. Okay, materials used in the construction of Guttu mane roofs included Mangalore roofing tiles, terracotta tiles, and glass tiles. Where Kodava houses were built? Kodagu, it's a place, Karnataka itself. Did I not see that? Okay. There may be other places where they were influenced by these and constructed later, but mainly it is from Karnataka. Okay, yeah. Guttu mane roofs, including Mangalore roofing tiles, terracotta tiles, and glass tiles to let in light. The availability of wood and skilled labor allowed these rich landlords to adorn their houses with exquisite woodwork, which was the signature of these homes. I'll show you a picture. Not exactly exquisite, but you know, basic style. As time progressed, okay, rich people started making the same houses with more of aesthetic, please. This one, as it goes everywhere. Okay, this is the Guttu house, traditional Guttu house. Malnad house will come again. Okay. Wanted to start with this. Riang house, Tripura. Okay. Riang tribals of Tripura built their houses with bamboo, used as a primary material for construction. In some cases, even the thatch roof is made of bamboo leaves. These houses are typical hill dwellings constructed on wooden bamboo stilts. To create a large horizontal platform, the floor of the house. Okay, the bamboo posts are arranged on a square grid and inclined whole bamboo members strengthen them. A required number of posts extend above the surface of the floor platform to support the roof structure. Meaning, some of the wooden posts which are there for the stilts, they also extend up above the roof so that they may support the roof also. Not all of the posts, some of them. The plan of the Riang house is normally a long rectangle. Okay. Roof slopes downwards on either sides. Boards made of flattened bamboo cums are used to cover the floor of the room and to make walls and doors. Okay, this is the typical bamboo construction. They are always made from stilts. Why? Because the hills are not even. The hills, this one is not even. So they make it even through stilts. Then the floor is made. Then the house is constructed. Okay. Yes. See one of these. This, which is there. This bamboo stilt. Okay. It extends until the roof so that it can support both the roof and the floor. Okay. Vada. Vadas are a rich and cherished architectural heritage in Maharashtra, reflecting the pride, religion, culture, traditions, and turbulent history of Marathas. Any movie that you've seen based on Maharashtra culture will have vadas, or again, traditional houses, these are, okay? The concept came into existence during the Peshwas in the 1730s. This is the structure of a typical vada. Again, it may change based on the usability of it, but this is a typical one. This is a vada. If you have visited Maharashtra villages and rural areas, you may have seen them. Okay, very beautiful one. As time went, they constructed it more and more beautifully. Okay, it became a work of art actually. The northeastern housing, in general, this is okay. Agricultural typologies have developed in the Northeast as factors of tradition, climate, and functionality, obviously. Okay. Tradition is there. The houses are constructed based on what climate it is and how it should be used. The materials used are locally available materials like bamboo, cane leaves, mud, and lime. Okay. Cane, as you can see, it's important here. Nowhere else we have seen it as a main construction element. Of late, bricks, stone chips, rock slabs, surki, etc. are also being used. Okay. Sloping roofs are a common architectural feature in all these typologies because of high rainfall in Northeast. Okay. What is surki?
Mud kind of a thing?
Yes. Whatever materials you see in Indian, especially Indian, traditional Indian style, no? They're all in one way or the other connected to clay. That is the, you know, semi-pakka houses. A combination of the kaccha and pakka style together forms semi-pakka house. Okay, it has evolved as villagers have acquired the resources to add elements constructed of the durable materials characteristic of a pakka house. Okay, its architecture has always evolved organically as the needs and resources of the local people residing in the specific region. The characteristic feature of semi-pakka houses are that these houses have walls made from pakka material such as brick, in cement, lime mortar, stone, clay, tile, etc. But the roof construction is done in the kaccha way using thatch, bamboo, etc. as the principal material of construction. Construction of these houses employs less manual labor than that of the pakka houses. Thatch roofing uses mud adobe walls with lime plaster. Okay, they are saying it has evolved as villagers have acquired the resources to add elements. First they had a kacha house, then they got the resources to build a more durable house, so durable materials were used and pakka houses were constructed, meaning the walls of it are made of pakka materials, meaning brick, cement, lime, mortar, okay, stone, clay, etc. The roof of it though is constructed using thatch, meaning typical kacha house material. Okay, again it differs based on the usage of the people, based on the region they live in. Okay, this is a typical in mud concrete in plinth. Where are these constructed? This has no specific region as such. Semi-pakka houses can be seen in rural areas all over India. Okay. Unless, you know, the construction style of the place is different. There's no specific place as such. Same like kacha and pakka houses. Ikra house. Ikra houses are single-story structures consisting of brick or stone masonry walls up to about 1 meter above the plinth. Okay, this masonry supports the walls consisting of bamboo woven together with a wooden frame and plastered with cement or mud plaster. Okay, these are in Sikkim, a northeast area. So the I told you, right, the typology of northeastern housing is very similar. That means they have the raised plinth, okay, 1 meter above the plinth, and the roofs are slanting, so that rain may fall off. This is a typical ikra house. Okay. Zalbak house. Okay. Traditional to the tribal region area of Mizoram, this vernacular architecture is a very simple house. It is made of thick bamboo mats, split bamboo poles or partitions, and thatched roof. This structure is used for teaching tribal traditions to the youth. In the northeast part of India, thatched roof, bamboo frames, hay, and straw are integral materials or to construction. Split bamboo poles means what? They cut the bamboo poles vertically and they can use it however they want. If they want to flat, something like that. Okay. This is a typical, again, traditional Zalbak house. Constructed modern way, I feel. Okay. Any doubt till now? I know this is a lot. Okay, I'll be sending this to Sir Gaurav Sir. He'll put it in the app and you guys can look from there. Okay. It has today's type of houses along with yesterday's also. Okay. So you can see it leisurely around. Okay, I've left out forts on purpose because forts have their own style of construction, so is there. Okay, they have a specific requirement to have. So that we'll do a little in detail later, but these are the small ones which you can do now. Okay, any doubt?
No.
Great. In the paper, I think they will ask you, you know, a typical house, show your picture and from where it is, probably. Okay, they may change it also. They may ask for construction material also. That is very probable. So pay special attention to it and the general area from which the houses are built. All of them may not have it. Which are there, you keep. Remember it. Okay. Now, sorry. Somebody said something.
Excuse me, miss.
Yes.
आप मुझसे पूछो मैं आपको. Miss, इस topic में कैसे question आएंगे?
वही. They may ask you questions regarding like this.
बताएंगे इस topic के अगर आप please वो.
Yes, I heard you. They may give you a picture of the house and ask you from where it is. ओके okay? या फिर वो पूछ सकते हैं, जैसे अभी मैंने नॉर्थ ईस्ट का बोला ना, So they may do something like they will ask you the general, they'll give you options of the general materials and ask which of these materials can be used in MSQ, MCQ, those stuff. In MSQ question, they may ask these type. Again, till now for this last paper, they asked only one type where they gave you the picture of the type of house and asked from where it is. This was international, but they may ask for Indian also. They will ask. Okay. Possibilities are endless. We will prepare for other. Okay. Does it answer your question? Alright, I'm assuming yes.
Yeah, Pooja ma'am, I'm audible to you.
Yes, sir, you are.
So, ma'am, you have given work to the students?
I will be giving them now.
Okay. So, okay, fine. So whatever work you are giving, you can explain it. So YouTube viewers also can do that. And they can submit to on WhatsApp number 99720469111. And you can submit your work and then for the next class, you will get the Zoom link as well. Okay, the YouTube, this is for YouTube viewers, whoever is seeing this video. So ma'am is going to give the work. You guys do it, and when you finish that work, submit on this number 99720469111. It's a WhatsApp number. You can submit your work, and then you will get the Zoom link for tomorrow's class. Day after tomorrow, and ma'am will discuss about that. Okay, ma'am. When you will give the homework, please explain it.
Sure. Okay, so your work for students on who are live, for them it's homework. Here for our students, it's just work for now. Okay, you have to make a list of architectural styles, international architectural styles. Okay, international only for now. Okay, we have done in previous classes before your exam. We have done Indian architectural styles. We'll do them again though. Okay, but in your question paper, they had asked what Gothic architectural style, if I'm not wrong. They had given you, shown you pictures of key features of that style and asked you which style, architectural style it is. So you don't have to find the key features. If you find them, write them down. Architectural style names, okay? Possibly which era they were in, century. If you get it, good. If you don't, leave it, okay? Key features, just wordings, okay? Pictures you may not get, you will get it. For now, students, you will not, okay? At least, 15 architectural styles, but be careful. There are a lot of architectural styles and I want you guys to, you know, keep in mind, you have to write the important architectural styles. There are many architectural styles where it is a combination of two original ones, okay? Don't write the combination. Indo-Gothic, okay, those kinds. You just try the original architectural style. For example, Renaissance architectural style is there. Gothic, for example, Victorian is there. Roman is there. Many are there, actually. Okay. So I want you guys to make a list of architectural styles. Key features of it. Okay. I'll make a list of it. And next class, we'll be discussing them in detail. Okay. Any doubt? All right. So I finished, you know, explaining the work. So. Gaurav sir?
Yes, ma'am. You have given the homework?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.